In this video, we'll cover the latest updates and news for Amazon FBA sellers. That includes the announcement and confirmation for the exact date for Prime Day in 2021, a new listing status that was just announced, and the huge amount of money sitting by aggregators waiting to buy Amazon FBA businesses, and more topics. Hi, this is Tomer from sourcingmonster.com, where I share videos, updates, and tutorials about Amazon FBA. I'm a seven-figure seller, and all the information and updates that I share here on the channel is completely free. Now, as we go through the video, if you find value in it, make sure you give me a thumbs up and you also subscribe to the channel. And all links for everything I'm going to mention in this video will be down below in the description section. Our first topic is that Amazon announcing the exact, not the exact date, but they confirmed that the Prime Day will be in June. I give credit to this article to CNET. When is Amazon Prime Day 2021? Until last week, we fully expected a return to July. Following last year, it was in October, if you remember. During a quarterly earnings call, however, Amazon confirmed that Prime Day will take place before the end of the second quarter, and that means before the end of June. The exact dates are still unknown, but we can speculate. Father's Day 2021 is on Sunday, June 20th, so there is a chance Amazon might choose the Tuesday and Wednesday after that, June 22nd or 23rd, and 23rd, I'm sorry. Or we might be looking at the week prior, effectively allowing the sale to continue with last minute Father's Day shopping. Of course, it could happen earlier in June. So that's a date and announcing that they didn't really again confirm the exact date, but we know that it will be in June. And the expectation is to be, like they said, on June 22nd and 23rd. There is a new status, new listing status on Amazon. I give credit to sellerunion.com. And we used to know that, or we used to have the active, we used to have the suppressed, and we used to have the inactive. Now they added a couple of new ones. So blocked unless FBA, actually, if I'm not wrong, that was also a status that was already exist. Blocked until unless FBA. So for some categories, if it's FBA, you need special requirements and approvals. So you can only do it FBM. I got confused. So for certain categories, because it they require like approval, like toys, they will not allow you to ship it unless it's FBA. I had a very similar situation last year before Q4. They told me that you can ship those items only if the offers are FBA. Because, I don't know, they assume probably the toys, people want them very quick and they want to really keep the customer service level of Amazon.com. So that's why they, you know, they might do that. So your listing has been blocked due to the holiday selling requirements, and in order to have it, like I said, or the reactivated, it will be necessary to create a new listing. Suppressed, as we all know what it is, and if you don't, your listing has been hidden from Amazon. It could be many things. Usually, if it's suppressed, you can either give call to Amazon customer service, or sometimes you will get an email letting you know why it was suppressed. Inactive, this means that your listing has been blocked either due to compliant, customer product condition compliant, intellectual property rights infringement complaint, or suspected intellectual property rights infringement complaint, NCX rate. Inactive potential, high, low pricing error. Your listing with, this I didn't really see before. Your listing was deactivated because your price is a bit lower or higher than the average. Got you. Detail page removed. This is the new listing status tab, which I wanted to show you. It is present on listings which were removed due to suspected intellectual property rights infringement complaints. So that's the new status. It will help you. I think that it's better that they are creating more and more types of statuses, because it could really help you resolve the issue faster than if it's unknown. If there is a couple of statuses only, it's harder to get the listing up and running. 3.5 billion in 12 months to buy Amazon sellers. This is by Marketplace Pulse. And huge companies, we all know that I was part of the Amazon stores that these aggregators contacted to. I declined the offer to sell at this point, but huge companies collecting successful Amazon sellers has become an extremely popular business model in recent years. In just the first 4 months of 2021, 2.5 billion in capital has been raised by firms looking to aggregate third-party sellers on Amazon. This practice is worth keeping an eye on, especially for successful sellers that might eventually be approached by one of these aggregators. So they really wrote it, well said by them. Amazon is losing its grip on customers and letting some sellers reach out to them. So this is by CNBC. Amazon is quietly rolling out a way for some sellers on its site to engage with shoppers in a move that represents a departure from its historically tight controls over customers' data. Last week, Amazon began piloting a tool that enables U.S. companies that are part of the brand registry program to email marketing materials to shoppers who have opted to follow their brands. These companies can then notify these shoppers when they launch a new product or promotion. So it's very similar to email's newsletter. I'm going to make a video about this tool very soon. The follow button is featured in areas such as business store pages and videos on Amazon Live, Amazon Livestream. So if you noticed your Amazon store and Amazon brand, now they can follow you on Amazon Live. So that's a good feature. The follow button is featured in areas we told. This tool called Manage Your Customer Engagement is designed to drive repeat purchases for vendors and sellers to help build a more robust following an Amazon sprawling marketplace. In a video describing the tool, Amazon urges company to build their brand with Amazon. For now, the free tool is only available to members of brand registry. So again, I'm going to make video about it. And that's it for this video. I hope you kept yourself updated and notified with the latest news and updates for Amazon FBA sellers. I choose the really important topics. We have more news, and I got really great feedback from the previous videos. So I'm continuing the trend and giving you and sharing you those news from my perspective. And also, the market perspective, of course. Please like this video. It really helps me promote it and help more people. Subscribe to this channel if you didn't subscribe before. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.